Live at the Big Dome, this is Binibining Pilipinas 2016. Presented by ABS-CBN, Araneta Center, PLDT Home DSL, and Cream Silk.
Philippines, are you ready to party?
Neither of them have 25 Bacolod City. 24, Batangas.
Maria Giganta, 22, Cebu City.
Tessa Lillard, 21, Davao City.
Angelica Anita, 20, Oriental Mindoro.
Cicel Riera Bahante, 26, Uwasalbay, Bicol.
Christian Ramos, 25, Marikina City.
Beautiful.
Continues when Binibining Pilipinas 2016 returns.
Good evening, universe, the Philippines, and the Big Dome. Are we all ready to party tonight? Are you guys ready to party? Let me hear you cheer for your bets.
Hello.
Support siya ng mga Pinoy.
Saya dito ngayon.
Ang saya, sobra. Para tayo nag-do New Year ulit. Actually, alam nyo, grabe mga Pinoy pa rin talaga ang best pageant fans in the universe.
Let me hear you scream!
Di namin kayo marinig.
Hello and welcome everyone to the celebration and coronation night of Binibining Pilipinas 2016.
You know what, Casey? Tonight is a very big celebration because last year, for the very first time ever, we conquered the globe.
Yes, that's right. Pero the globe lang ba?
Hindi lang.
O ano?
Shortly after that, for our third time in our pageant history, the Philippines once again conquered the whole wide universe.
Universe!
Universe lang naman.
Oh, universe lang naman. Pero syempre siyan, universe of course, courtesy of our confidently beautiful with the heart, Miss Universe 2015, Pia Wurzbach. Again, salamat and congratulations, Pia. And the same goes to our stunning Miss Globe 2015, Anne Colis. They will join us later tonight. But for now, let's all welcome to our big party, our distinct board of judges. Representing the youth, a diligent university student, please welcome Mr. Paolo Rojas. ABS-CBN Head of Television Production, Direk Laurenti Jogi. A top-notch business executive and currently ABS-CBN's Chief Operating Officer for Broadcast, Miss Cory Vidanes. Another well-known businessman and former Philippine ambassador to Spain, please welcome His Excellency Joseph Lani Bernardo.
World-renowned painter and artist, Miss Betsy Westendorp de Brias.
A veteran diplomat with a stellar career spanning more than 27 years, the ambassador of the Russian Federation to the Philippines, His Excellency Igor Kovayev.
One of today's hottest and most sought-after actors, he is a licensed pilot who recently represented the Philippines in the International Paragliding Competition. Presenting Mr. Ian Veneracion. An esteemed diplomat who has recently been assigned to reopen the Danish Embassy in Manila, please welcome His Excellency Jan Tap Christiansen. Another career diplomat in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Belgium for more than 30 years, he has been assigned all over the world and now ambassador to the Philippines, presenting His Excellency Roland Romoltele. From Oklahoma, USA.
Wow.
Actress, model, and the second runner-up in the recent Miss Universe pageant. Please welcome the beautiful, the talented Olivia Jordan. A graduate of the University of California, Berkeley and Ateneo de Manila, please welcome the newly appointed Secretary of the Department of Trade and Industry, our Chairman of the Board of Judges, the Honorable Adrian Cristobal.
We would also like to acknowledge and thank our official tabulators, SGV and Company. Oh, we are so sure you guys will be very busy later tonight.
Sure, busy. And joining us tonight, here's our Binibining Pilipinas 2014 Queens, Bianca Guidotti, Chris Tiffany Hanson, and first runner-up, Laura Lehman, with more party guests in the house. Ladies.
Would shine on Philippine shores without the admirable ladies and gents of the Binibining Pilipinas Charity Incorporated. So please welcome Mrs. Betsy Westendorf Brias, Mr. and of course we have Mr. Raymond Villanueva. And with us tonight, the co-chairman of BPCI, Ms. Conchitina Sevilla Bernardo. And of course, the chairman of BPCI herself, Mrs. Stella Marquez Araneta.
Here's one more reason why our gathering tonight is lovely as mga kapamilya, because of course tonight we are also joined by the forever beautiful reigning queens who are also in the house. Hello ladies.
Nice to see you all as always, my peg in life, Laura. And now we have something else special in store. With us on stage is CN and Casey, all set to bring it tonight.
That's right, Laura. Definitely special is the right word to use because it is the first set of special awards and we're presenting them this early on as they are meant to ignite and fire up CNR party mode!
Party talaga tayo ngayon.
Oo, party.
Pero ito, Casey, first up, pag may party, siguradong siyang binibini na pinaka busy sa lahat.
Ah, talaga, pinaka busy.
Pero bago siya, meron tayong special
yes,
representative from SGV and Company.
Montes. Partner SGV and Company for the results. Thank you so much, sir.
We are going to introduce Binibining Friendship.
Ayan, kaya busy.
Chosen by her co-candidates and to receive 50,000 pesos worth of wardrobe from BPCI. This year's Binibining Friendship is... Binibini 16, Vina Opeñano.
On February 8th, the Binibinis showcase their singing and dancing prowess. Siyempre hindi mawawala yan siya. At the Gateway Activity Center, as they competed for the Binibining Best in Talent Award. The winner will receive 50,000 pesos worth of wardrobe items from BPCI. She is none other than...
Binibini.
Binibining Best in Talent Award.
Miss Talent is...
Binibini 16, Vina Opeñano.
Up next, we have the most photogenic or should I say the face of Binibini 2016. She will receive 25,000 pesos cash and a Fuji XP90 from Picture City. And the face of Binibini 2016 is...
May mga pet din sila eh, no?
Let me hear you guys scream, Binibini 31! Kylie Versosa.
The Binibinis and their very talented Filipino designers converged at the Kia Theater last April 6th for the much-anticipated Best in National Costume Competition. Now, let's take a look at the six Binibinis who emerged as finalists for this award. Costumes are just six of the 40 fabulous and exquisite national costumes, all designed and created by Filipino designers. Now, to determine who wins this award, an online voting was held, and from the six finalists, the pageant fans chose this year's Binibining Best in National Costume, and she happens to be Binibini 3 Angela Fernando.
Congratulations to the winners of our first set of special awards. Way to go, Binibinis.
And to present the awards for Binibining Friendship, Kimberly Suiza, Binibining Pilipinas second runner-up 2015. For Binibining Best in Talent, Yvette Santiago, Binibining Pilipinas Supra National 2014. For the face of Binibini, Mr. Paul Santos, President of Picture City, and Mutia Datur, Miss Supra National 2013. And for the Binibining Best in National Costume, Miss Ariela Arida, Miss Universe third runner-up 2013.
Binibinis, and now we would like to thank Jojo Bragais for our Binibinis official shoes, and actually mine tonight, Jeffrey Rogador, the designer who did those stylish swimwears our Binibinis were wearing during the official opening music video. Thanks, Jeff, and thanks, Jojo.
Well, you've mentioned swimsuits already, Bianca. Well, we will be seeing more of that when we return as the candidates will gear up for the swimsuit competition. So just sit back, relax, and we'll be right back.
Back here at Binibining Pilipinas 2016, and now we're off to our first round of the competition, CN. Sa lahat ng beauty ng nakikita natin ngayon, parang nakakalimutan natin na competition pala to.
Kaya nga, ito yung round na hottest talaga.
Yes, this is the first round and certainly the hottest.
So once again, here are this year's Binibinis and their swimsuits provided by Filipino designers Doms Ramos and Julius Hagio in the Binibining Pilipinas 2016 Swimsuit Competition. Beginning with Binibini 1, Gail Ventique. Garcia. Kimberly Petchor. Rihanna Pangindian.
Joanna Eden.
Report. I'm here backstage with our second round of Binibinis, and ladies, it's your turn in just a few minutes, and so I have to ask, what's the one thing that you don't want to happen when, number one, you're in a swimsuit, and number two, you're strutting yourself in front of millions of people on TV?
Of course, I don't want to trip on stage in my swimsuit.
Oh, ikaw naman, Binibini.
Yes, stage fright. Syempre, dapat confident.
And no wardrobe malfunction, please.
Sige, kaya nyo yan. You'll be fine. Everything will be smooth and gorgeous, ladies. So not to worry and best of luck.
And we are back here at the Big Dome. More Binibinis will swimsuit their way into our hearts. So let's keep the party rolling with our next batch of candidates in the Binibining Pilipinas 2016 Swimsuit Competition. Here is Binibining 21, Jessica Gonzalez. April Smith. Binibini 23, Angela Valdez. Niza Sabrina Limha. Jennifer Hammond. Crescent Samaco.
Thank you.
Bahante.
We will see our beyond beautiful Binibinis be transformed by cream silk for the evening gown competition, which is happening at the other end of this break. So stay tuned as our modern Filipina Binibinis take on the stage with grace, elegance, and beyond beautiful hair.
And we're back. Moving on to another highlight of the night. This is also another reason for us to celebrate because this year and from here on out, the evening gowns of all our Binibinis are all designed and created by Filipino designers.
Yes!
All 40 of them, woo! 100% Filipino made. And Casey, speaking of Filipino designers, I'd like to thank Odilon Simpao, Nat Manilag, and Francis Libiran, Style by Ton Lau, and Karen Donnie Bautista.
Yes, and I would like to thank my own designers for the night. These are all also proudly Filipino made. This is by Ivar Aceron, my dream suit dress. Thank you, Francis Libiran, Mark Boomgarner, Michael Leyva, Anthony Ramirez, and Rain Times M.
All right. 100% Filipino
made. Nakaka-proud talaga. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in the national costume competition, which we mentioned earlier, it is the dress or the costume that is judged. But in this next round, it's the Binibini herself and how she carries her gown, of course, that matters. So without further ado, let's stand back and stay awed by our lovely Binibinis in the Binibini Pilipinas 2016 Evening Gown Competition. Beginning, of course, with Binibini 1, Gail Ventic. Pension.
Joanna Eden.
Paula Rich Bartolome. Christine Stoke. Peñano. Binibining 17, Priscilla de la Cruz. Binibining 20, Keisha De Leon.
Miss Malaysia. And the Miss Universe organization is also partying with us tonight, headed by the president, Miss Paula Sugart. But for now, time for a quick break. More dazzling creations will fill up the stage later on when we return. See you then. First winner of the Miss Universe crown, Miss Gloria Diaz, still beautiful as ever. Miss
Gloria, I was just watching you on YouTube, and I was watching the pageant in 1969. So much has changed since then, right?
Very many things, yes.
And what can you say now that, because they say the Philippines is now a legitimate top powerhouse in the beauty pageant scene. Diba? What can you say about that?
I totally agree, I think. It's about time, right?
Yes, definitely. How do you think things have changed since 1969? Since the men on the moon came to planet Earth and went to your house and changed?
Well, many things have changed. The women have changed. They're taller, more beautiful, I think. And I think we have now 3 Miss Universes.
Yes, and you were the trailblazer for that. Kayo po ang nag-umpisa ng winning streak ng Miss Universe Philippines.
A long time ago.
But now that only Filipino designers, Miss Gloria, are designing the costumes and the gowns of all the Binibinis, how do you feel about that?
I think it's great, including my dress. Ramon made it for me. And usually I used to use always ready-made, imported. But now our designers are very, very good, very talented. The designs of the clothes were beautiful.
I must agree, definitely world class. And you were, of course, one of the first to prove that in our country, bringing home the first Miss Universe crown with a lady, Niba. And of course, I just want to thank you so much for joining us, for celebrating with us. Again, this is a party, it's a celebration as much as it is a competition. Is there anything you would like to say to our Binibinis of 2016?
Well, like always, YOLO, you live only once, right?
Yeah.
So make the most of it, enjoy it, and I'm sure we'll have another winner soon, maybe in the Miss Universe.
Yes, a back-to-back win. Hopefully, who's to say it can't happen, right?
Yes, why not?
Thank you very much, Ms. Gloria Diaz.
Thank you.
The ever beautiful.
And good luck to everyone.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, now here are 20 more Binibini Glamazons out to impress all of us here at the Binibining Pilipinas 2016 Evening Gown Competition. Ms. Gloria, we will be starting with Binibini 21, Jessica Gonzalez. April Smith.
Lying down beside you, what's going through your head? The silence in the air.
Binibini 23, Angela Valdez.
And
Jennifer Hammond.
Out of time, I would have died. gigante.
For tonight, I personally would like to thank my designers Gakuya by Kim Gan and Bessie Basana, as well as Chris Bonar and Jacatel. Up next, we have the second set of special awards, so don't change the channel. And at this juncture, we shall present our second set of special awards.
Will your bets bag any award tonight? Any cheers? Any numbers? Well, that's what we are about to find out.
Ayun, ang dami. Grabe kayo, Araneta. Okay. Let's start with Miss Philippine Airlines. The winner of Binibining Miss Philippine Airlines can start packing her luggage because she will receive 2 round-trip business class tickets to any PAL International point. And the winner of Miss Binibining Philippine Airlines happens to be...
Binibini Manila Bulletin Reader's Choice Award because she will receive a vacation and pampering treat at the Manila Hotel worth 100,000 pesos. And that lucky
sponsorship from JAG, this fashionista happens to be Binibining. Is one that many pageant fans would consider the most prestigious. This is the Binibining Best in Swimsuit, who captures the most attention because of her awesome curves and natural allure. The winner of this year's Best in Swimsuit will receive 75,000 pesos worth of BPCI wardrobe, and she is none other than Binibining.
Our Binibinis have transformed over the weeks into exceptionally elegant modern Filipinas, especially tonight in their evening gowns. They have been transformed to beyond a beautiful with cream silk. Tonight, our Binibining Best in Long Gown will receive 75,000 pesos worth of wardrobe from BPCI and a one-year supply of cream silk. And she is Binibining. She is Binibining number 26, Jennifer Hamon.
The special award for Miss Cream Silk goes to the Binibining who has transformed to become the best version of herself. She is now empowered not only with beyond beautiful hair thanks to cream silk, but she is also empowered with the confidence to achieve limitless possibilities.
She will be the brand ambassadress of cream silk, the epitome of the modern Filipina, with a beauty that can inspire other Filipinas to start their journey of transformation. Last year, our Miss Cream Silk was none other than our very own reigning Miss Universe, Miss Pia Alonso-Wurzbach. So there are definitely huge things in store for this year's Miss Cream Silk winner.
And aside from being a brand ambassador, she will also be receiving a one-year supply of cream silk and a 100,000 peso cash prize. And this year's Miss Cream Silk is no other than Binibining. She is Binibining number 28, Nicole Manalo.
And to present their awards for Binibining Philippine Airlines, Mr. Jaime J. Bautista, President and COO of Philippine Airlines, Ms. Rhea C. Domingo, Vice President for Marketing, Philippine Airlines, for Binibining Manila Bulletin Reader's Choice Award, Ms. Vanette Cunana, Public Relations Manager, Manila Bulletin, Mr. Barbie Agenza, External Affairs Head, Manila Bulletin, for CISO JAG 2015, Mr. James Perry, Country Operations Head for JAG, for Binibining Best in Swimsuit, MJ Lastimosa, Miss Universe Philippines 2014, for Binibining Best in Evening Gown and Binibining Cream Silk, Miss Drew Capullo, Brand Manager for Cream Silk, Miss Apples Abilin, Head of PR Unilever Philippines, and Maria Venus Ra, Miss Universe 2010 Fourth Runner-Up.
Congratulations to our special awardees. Now, from 40, our Binibinis will be trimmed down to this year's top 15 finalists. That's happening after the break.
We're back! Araneta, are you ready?
Are you guys ready for the top 15? Isa pa. Are you guys ready for the top 15? Binibinis, good luck. Being handed to us now, representative of SGV and Company, Mr. Lito Montes, contains the names of our 15 candidates.
Yes, our 15. Top 15 Binibinis. Nako, ito na yon. Ladies and gentlemen, pasok kaya sa top 15 ang mga bet ninyo.
This year's top 15. And this is going in no particular order. Please proceed upstage, our first Binibini top 15 finalist, Binibini. Binibini 31, Kylie Versosa. Rihanna Pangintian.
Binibini 38, Angelica Alita.
Come on down, Binibini 22, April Smith.
Five down, 10 more to go. Binibini 9, Rochelle Navarro Tobia.
Next, we have Binibini 4, Kimberly Pinchon.
Binibini 13, Joanna Eden.
Show us your beautiful smile, Binibini 29, Maxine Medina.
You're still in, Binibini 27, Dindi Pajares.
Ten down, five more to go. Up next we have Binibini 26, Jennifer Hammond. Tonight is your lucky night, Binibini 37, Jessamine Hewler.
Of course, she did not disappoint. Binibini 28, Nicole Marie Manalo.
But definitely not the least, Binibini! Binibini! 12! Edmund Joy Gamboa!
Yes!
Grab it!
We have our top 15!
Our top 15! The list is complete, ladies and gentlemen! This is your Binibini Pilipinas 2016 Top 15 finalists. Congratulations and thank you to all the Binibinis. You've all made this competition the toughest ever.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's the question and answer with a twist when we return, so stick around.
Big Dome and the viewers at home are all set to hear what our Binibinis have to say and share in our question and answer round.
That's right, CN. And as I mentioned earlier, it is question and answer with a twist. Alam mo bakit with a twist?
Bakit with a twist?
Kasi ano yan eh, ang usual process is the Binibinis will pick the name of the judge who will ask them the question. But this time around, we will turn the tables, okay? So it's actually the judges who will pick their Binibini for the next Binibini in line for the question and answer part of the competition.
And the top 15 ladies here, hindi nila alam which order. They don't know.
Oh, they won't know when their turn will be.
So that's why it's very nerve-wracking, and yun ang ayong twist na sinasabi.
Yes,
diba?
We have the top 15 now on stage. Excited na lahat ng supporters ng top 15.
And of course, Bianca and Chris will help us in this round as they will approach our judges when it's their turn to pick and ask. But before we start, let us inform everyone, our top 15, each Binibini only has 30 seconds to answer. And when you hear this sound, that means your time is up. All right.
That's right. I'm ready to begin. Are you ready? I think we're all ready to begin. Ready na ba tayo?
Are you guys ready?
Q&A!
Ready na ang ating mga Binibinis? Let's start with our first judge, Mr. Paulo Rojas.
My question is for Binibini 12. Here's my question. One of Miss Universe Pia Wurzbach's advocacies is to stop cyberbullying. How will you help her with this advocacy?
If I win Binibining Pilipinas tonight, of course, I will have the crown. And having a crown is influential. And I will use my convincing aura of beauty to influence especially the youth that they shouldn't let anyone mix inferior. That would be all. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Binibini 12.
Edgelin Gamboa. Our second judge for the night to choose his Binibini, Direk Laurenti Jogi.
My question is for Binibini 27. Dindi, in a few months, we will have a new set of country leaders. What is your message to our next president?
My message for the next president is to be a person of being competent, a person who is transparent, and he or she should be someone with a desire to serve the people. I just want to tell him that have a heart of a hero that is willing to fight for the sovereign dignity of our country. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Binibini 27, Dindi Pajares.
Thank you, Binibini. Mukhang nagustuhan ng audience natin ang sagot niya. Our third judge to ask the question, our boss, na ako rin kinakabahan ngayon, Miss Cory Vidanes.
My question is for Binibini 29, Maxine Medina. Maxine, even if her parents can afford to send her to school, a 15-year-old girl wants to stop her studies. What would be your advice to her?
I would tell a little girl to study hard, no matter what their parents would tell them, because having an education is something that cannot have that anybody else. But education can make you even a better person. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Binibini 29, Maxine Medina.
Ganda ng message, education can
yes
give so much, di ba? All right, our next judge.
Ambassador Joseph Lani Bernardo.
Binibining 28. What is the toughest challenge a Filipina of your age faces nowadays?
For me, the toughest challenge that Filipina of woman today faces is to be courageous, determined, and resilient. But what I would advise to her is to continue to have that quality. Because when you have that quality, you can always stand for what you believe in. You can make things happen, and you can transform not just yourself, but the society into a best version of it. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibining 28. Nicole Manalo.
Binibining 28, Nicole Manalo. Our fifth judge to ask the question. Ambassador Igor Kovayev.
My question goes to Binibining 37. How will you encourage a Filipino citizen who is feeling hopeless to cast his or her vote?
I would encourage a person who is hopeless by changing his mindset. When you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibining 37, Jessamy Huelar.
Binibining 37.
Our next judge, Secretary Adrian Cristobal.
My question is for Binibining 11. Nicole, if you could switch bodies with somebody for one day, who would it be and why?
If I could switch bodies with somebody for one day, it would probably be our current president, because I would like to know how he handled every decision he ever made. It must have been so hard, even though it is sometimes unpopular. I would like to know how he brought the Philippines from being the sick man of Asia to the bright spot of Asia. I would like to get I would like to know how he thinks, how we get advice from our president. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibining 11. Nicole Cordobes.
Our next judge, Miss Olivia Jordan.
My question is for Binibining 31. Hi, Kylie. This question may sound familiar to you because it was a similar question to the final at Miss Universe. Why do you deserve to win a Binibining Pilipinas crown tonight?
The person who deserves to win a Binibining Pilipinas crown tonight is the person who has worked hard for it and is willing to do everything to continue the legacy of the Philippines. She is confident with an attitude and personality, and has a personality, and I believe I am her. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibining 31, Kylie Verzosa.
That's Binibining 31.
Are you okay, Cian?
I'm good.
How are you holding up with all these beautiful, intelligent answers, intelligent Binibinis?
Iba yung tension dito sa stage.
You know,
when everyone's just quiet, pag tahimik silang lahat, parang, What do I say, right?
Yeah, giving them the chance to think and really give the best answer, and they have not disappointed so
far. It's not easy to be up here right now. All right, our next judge, Ambassador Roland Remortele.
My question goes to Binibining 26. This is the question. Winning one of the crowns tonight will make you your country's ambassador of goodwill. What international problem or issue would you focus on, and how will you address the problem?
I would focus on terrorism, because I think that is one of the major problems of the world right now, and I will encourage people to fight for their beliefs by kind words, by communication, because I think that communication begets understanding, and understanding begets tolerance, and tolerance begets peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Binibini 26, Jennifer Hammond.
Binibini 26, 8 down. 7 more coming up after we take a quick break. Para naman ma-relax tayo dito.
Oh, that's right. You surely would not want to miss our remaining 7 finalists in their Q&A. So stay where you are and see you all in a bit on Binibining Pilipinas 2016.
Welcome back, everyone. We're still here in the Q&A round, and it's time to keep the questions coming for our remaining 7 finalists.
Yes, that's right. We have our remaining 7 finalists, and we will proceed this time, beginning with our first judge of this round, Miss Betsy Westendorp Brias.
My question is for Binibining 9. My question is for Binibining 9. Would you compromise your integrity and personal values just to win a crown? Why or why not?
I won't compromise my integrity just to win the crown, because for I believe what I stand for. I will just do my best just to do what is right, for I believe God always sees everything that we do. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini 9. Rochiela Tobias.
For our next judge asking the question, Mr. Ian Veneracion.
This question is for Binibini 22. The question is, women use makeup to enhance their facial features. Do you think it is appropriate for men to do the same?
For me, I think it's not. Because if you do believe your physical attribute is beautiful, then you wouldn't do any, put on any makeup on your face. And then if any woman would accept who you are and as you are, this includes the strength of a man and weaknesses to learn and to grow more. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini. 22, April Smith. Ambassador Yantop Christensen.
My question goes to Binibini 13, Joanna Eden. And here comes a very easy question. If you are to choose between having a multi-million business or a crown, what would you choose and why?
This might sound cliche, but I really think I would choose to have the crown, because with the crown
comes the, not the responsibility, but the ability to inspire other people. And I really think if we start with each individual, we can help better the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini 13.
Binibini 13, Joanna Eden.
Our next judge to ask the question. Again, Miss Olivia Jordan.
My question is for Binibini number 5. If you had the chance to ask our own Miss Universe, Pia Wurzbach, one question, what would that question be?
I would ask our Miss Universe, Pia Alonso Wurzbach, how does it feel to compete in Miss Universe? I would like to get some advice from her. And more than that, I would like to ask about her advocacy and how she is constantly beautiful with a heart and bringing joy and bringing pride and honor to our country. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini 5, Rihanna Pangindigan.
We're down to our fifth judge, Secretary Adrian Cristobal Jr.
This is for Binibini 38. Angelica, what do you think is the most undervalued profession right now, and why?
I would say that the most undervalued profession right now is being a teacher. Because I believe that the teachers have a very big impact in the students right now. Like, they teach us every single thing we have to know, whether it comes to social issues, to physical things we have to fix, but they haven't been appreciated much. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini 38. Angelica Alita.
We would like to call on Miss Corey Vidanes, please.
My question is for Binibini 4. Kimberly May, what kind of leaders do Filipinos need today?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. For me, the kind of leader that Filipinos need today is a parental leader, someone who is parent enough, someone who sympathizes with the people, someone who encourages them to go forward and approach their goals. Thank you.
Binibini 4, Kimberly Penchon.
Our last judge to ask the question, the guy willing to give free kisses and hugs dito sa Araneta, Mr. Ian Veneracion.
This question is for Binibini 16. And the question is, if men and women are equal, why do you think men ought to give their seats to women in public transports?
I think because they are gentlemen, and being a man, they should be gentle to each woman. And I believe that we are all connected. What you do can help us, and what we do can help everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Binibini 16, Vina Opeñano.
And there you have it, guys. Thank you to all of our top 15 finalists, and congratulations for making it this far.
Definitely.
So guys, the competition is now officially closed.
Ladies and gentlemen, their scores will now be tabulated, but meanwhile, here are Bianca, Chris, and Laura for more surprises.
Now when we get back, our very own Miss Universe,
Pia Alonso-Wurzbach will be joining us along with the other queens of 2015. So stay tuned, stay here, because you wouldn't want to miss this.
Over the past 5 years, the Philippines has been winning international crowns and titles in all pageants, one after the other, making our country a certified powerhouse.
That's right, and we would obviously like to thank all of our former queens, but tonight belongs to the reigning Binibini queens of 2015. We will forever be grateful, of course, for their huge accomplishments, but tonight, Cian, it is time for them to pass on their crowns to the deserving winners this year.
Mga kapamilya, the traditional farewell walk begins with Miss Globe 2015, Ann Collis. Binibining Pilipinas Tourism and Lorraine Collis.
It has been a beautiful year filled with surprises and success. Being the first Filipina to win Miss Globe changed my whole perspective about being a woman and a Filipino. I will never forget the warm support and the loudest cheers of my kababayans when I competed in Toronto, Canada. I am proud to represent the modern global Pinay. I am grateful for all the blessings and the sweet victories. Thank you, Lord God, this is all for you. To my family, you are my great source of happiness and inspiration. To Madam Stella Marquez Araneta and the BPCI, thank you so much for trusting me to represent our country in Miss Globe. To my mentors, thank you for bringing out the best in me. To my Binibini sisters, congratulations. I am very proud of you. To my successor, I dare you to be different. I dare you to make a difference. Don't forget to speak from the heart and smile. Lastly, to our kababayans all over the globe, para sa inyo ang karangalan na ito. Let us not forget that we Filipinos are world class. Angat at laging panalo ang ganda at puso ng Pinay. Dakal pong salamat, mabuhay ang Pilipinas. I am Ann Collis, the first Filipina Miss Globe.
Binibini Pilipinas Super National 2015, Rogelie Katakuta!
It was this very moment a year ago when I was blessed to wear the Binibini Pilipinas Supranational Crown. But there is more to being a woman with a title. I had a chance to be a role model, and the different charitable activities made my experience more meaningful and memorable. I represented our country at the 2015 Miss Supranational Pageant in Poland. I gave it my all and made my countrymen proud. That was my greatest achievement. To our lovely Binibinis, I wish for you to be strong and never give up on your dreams. To my Binibini family and Madam Stella Marquez Araneta, I am deeply privileged to have been one of your queens. To my mentors, family, friends, daghang salamat kaninyong tanan. To the Almighty God, this journey is not possible without you. Tonight, my reign ends, but I will always be Rogelie Katakutan, your Binibini Pilipinas Supranational 2015.
Binibini Pilipinas Intercontinental, Christy Lynn McGarry.
It's been a year of extreme growth and extreme sacrifice, but all for the good and all for the better. Words cannot express the gratitude I have for the experiences and opportunities I've been given during my reign. I've learned and grown so much. I've molded my mind and heart to fit so many hats. And above that, I've come to really embrace who I am in the skin I'm in, and excited to reveal to myself what more I'm capable of. All this would not be possible without the help and constant support of the people around me throughout this journey. Firstly, I have to thank BPCI and Madame Stella Araneta for seeing my potential and trusting me with the responsibility to fulfill my duties. To my batch sisters, we did it. You girls are so amazing, and I've come to learn and love each one of you. To my closest friends, mentors, and family, you all are my rocks. I could never have done it without you. To the overseas Filipino communities and those in my hometown of Nabuaca, Marina Sur, thank you for your utmost and unlimited support. This was for you. And lastly, to the Philippines,
thank you for your pride. We are a strong and beautiful nation with beautiful-hearted people, and I couldn't be more proud to wear the Philippine sash. The best message I can give to all of you is to strive to be the best at whatever you do and believe that nothing is impossible. I am Christy Lynn Landrido McGarry, your Miss Intercontinental first runner-up.
For Binibining Pilipinas International 2015,
winning a Binibining Pilipinas title is a gift that I received from God. All the experiences that I had and this journey made me the person I am now. I want to say thank you to all the people behind my success for their love, guidance, and training. I know that being a beauty queen is not an easy task, but I love what I've done and will continue to do despite all the struggles that go with it. I had the opportunity to share my thoughts, my heart, and my advocacies to many people. This is why being a Binibini Queen truly makes me proud. To my family and loved ones, God bless you all. To Mrs. Stella Marquez Araneta, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to represent the Philippines to the world. The love and support of all the Filipinos around the world was so overwhelming, and it helped me boost my confidence in everything that I did. My success in this journey is something that I will cherish forever. I am Jana Salubina, your Binibining Pilipinas International.
Philippines
2015
is Binibini 10.
Pia Alonso
Miss Universe
2015. Please welcome the pride of our country, Miss Universe 2015, Pia Alonso Wurzbach.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Nais ko pong magsimula sa pamamagitan ng pagbigay ng taus-pusong pasasalamat sa Diyos at sa buong sambayan ng Pilipino Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. In the years that I have appeared on this very same stage, my biggest realization is that you should never give up on your dreams. We should never waver in our perseverance and never let obstacles hinder our progress. A dream is a picture of a possibility, and we should have a strong heart and a prepared mind to turn that into reality. In this moment, I'd like to express my sincerest gratitude to the people who have helped me win Miss Universe. If it wasn't for you, I would have not have achieved this humble achievement. Most especially to Binibining Pilipinas Charities, led by Madam Stella Marquez Araneta. To my family, you are my life coaches. To Aces and Queens, my mentors. To my friends, who are my anchors and make sure that I'm humble all the time. To the Pianatics, who are my angels and who defend me all the time. Thank you so much. And to my successor, just remember to give your best. Behind that beautiful gown, your knees may be trembling, like me right now. I'm still not used to it. And being in front of millions of people is nerve-wracking. But you have to remember that you are proudly wearing that sash that says Philippines. And believe me, in your moments of doubt, you just have to remember that you have the whole country cheering you on. Tonight, I feel like I'm graduating from Binibining. Tonight, it's the beginning of a journey for a confidently beautiful Filipina. Mabuhay ang gandang Pilipina. Mabuhay ang Pilipina. Mabuhay tayong lahat.
Mabuhay ang reyna ng 2015. We're just a couple of minutes away from finding out who these queens will crown as their successors. So mga kapamilya dito sa Big Dome and at home, bawal matulog kasi we will be right back.
Thank you.
It's cheering time again. Universe, the Philippines, and the Big Dome. Are you guys ready to find out this year's winners?
I think they're more than ready, C, and I don't think we should keep them waiting any longer.
Excited na lahat dito eh.
Oh, grabe, kabado na rin lahat.
Handing the envelope to us now, once again, Mr. Lito Montes from SGV and Company. Maraming salamat po.
All right. Whew. Before we make the announcements, once again, maraming salamat, Binibining Pilipinas Charities Incorporated. Thank you for spearheading this project all these decades. Mabuhay ang BPCI. Ladies and gentlemen, 6 titles or crowns are at stake. But before we get there, we will first announce this year's runners-up, beginning with the second runner-up.
Second, of course, comes the first runner-up. The Binibining Pilipinas 2016 first runner-up is none other than Binibini 38, Angelica Alita.
To present the award is Binibining Pilipinas 2015 first runner-up, Hannah Ruth Cecil.
Pilipinas Globe 2016. I wonder who could be the first queen of the night, Cien? The Binibining Pilipinas Globe 2016 is Binibini 28, Nicole Marie Manalo.
And the crown for here's Miss Globe 2015, Ann Collins.
Out next, the title of Binibining Pilipinas Grand International 2016. Who could she be? Binibini 11, Nicole Orlovis.
And to crown her as Miss Grand International 2015 third runner-up, Harul Shah.
On its way on stage is the third crown. The crown for Binibining Supranational 2016. Now, which will be owned beginning tonight by one beautiful and blessed Binibini? This year's Binibining Supranational is none other than Binibini 13, Joanna Eden.
And to crown her, here's Binibining Pilipinas Supranational 2015, Rochely Katakuta.
Crowns have been passed on. 3 more remaining on the heads of our reigning queens. is our Binibining Pilipinas Intercontinental 2016. She is none other than Binibining. Binibining 26, Jennifer Hammond.
And to crown her, here's Miss Intercontinental 2015 first runner-up, Christy McGarry.
Mabuhay ang Pilipinas at magandang gabi. See you all next year.